Hello everyone, in this video we will see about failure of weir on permeable foundation and accordingly how to prevent this failure. That is what we will be seeing in this video. So what is permeable foundation? Permeable foundation means if suppose this is the soil, there is no impervious structure, so it allows the flow of water underneath the surface. That is known as permeable foundation. So if suppose this is the weir and there is head of water on the upstream, which I am denoting by U bar S, and there is downstream. So this weir can fail due to two reasons. One is subsurface flow and other is surface flow. So what is subsurface flow? Subsurface flow is the flow of water underneath the ground surface. So what happens is there is a differential head, as you can see. Head on the upstream is large because weir blocks the water, because of which there is head on the upstream, and downstream there is not much head when the water does not flow through the weir, when the gates are not open. So because of the difference in head, what happens is there is flow of water underneath the ground surface. As you can see in the 3D image also, there is flow of water underneath the ground surface. That is known as seepage, and that is subsurface flow. So this failure of weir can happen due to subsurface flow also, and also because of surface flow. So when water flows over the weir, there is hydraulic jump occurs, which acts in the upward direction, which tends to break away the foundation, and also scouring of particles take place. So failure can happen due to surface flow also. Now let us see the failure which happens due to subsurface flow. So the first one is uplift failure. So what is this uplift failure? So as you can see, there is a head of water on the upstream. This head of water on the upstream, if suppose these are the soil particles, and if you insert a piezometer here, you will find that the water rises up to the head of water. So this head of water, it applies force on these particles and tends to force the particle apart, that is break away from each other. So because of which there is a pressure developing. So the water which is inside these pores of soil, pressure develops inside this pores. So this pore water pressure, which happens because of this head of water, it exerts uplift, and it is uplift because as it tends to force the particle apart, the contact force reduces between the particles. So because of which the soil strength reduces, which can be taken as it is acting upward. So this pressure which develops as the water is inside the pores is known as pore water pressure. So this pore water pressure contributes to the uplift. So this uplift can be prevented by the floor weight. If suppose this is the weir and you provide some flooring here with concrete or something, so the weight of concrete will act downward, and this is the uplift. So if this weight of concrete can balance this uplift, then there is no problem. And you know the head is maximum at the upstream, and at the downstream head is less. And also because of seepage, the uplift pressure keeps on decreasing. When there is seepage, water flows from one upstream to downstream. When water flows from upstream to downstream, what happens is this head keeps on reducing. The head of water at upstream, and this is the head of water downstream. It can be assumed to drop constantly as water seeps through. So the pressure of water held by the pores where there is maximum head, and it keeps on decreasing. So uplift will be maximum at the upstream. So if this is the uplift pressure, if it can be drawn like this, so the uplift pressure is maximum at the upstream and very minimum at the downstream, depending on the head of water. So when there is no flow, that is the most dangerous condition. Like when the weir is gates are closed, there is maximum water on upstream and there is very minimum water on downstream. So this is the dangerous condition for which the uplift failure is designed. And also, as you see from this image, only on the upstream side there is uplift pressure, and on the downstream side it is very less. So it is how to prevent this uplift. So as you know, as you saw, when water seeps through, the head of water keeps on decreasing. So when you provide this seepage path to go vertically, if you provide some sort of pile arrangement here, so what happens is the water seeps through like this. They cannot go directly, so you allow the water to seep all the way along. So when the, depending on the length of this pile, a lot of head is lost in this. If head of water is reduced, automatically pore water pressure is reduced, because of which there is less uplift. And also you should provide sufficient floor thickness to act downward to balance the uplift. The next interesting part is known as piping or undermining failure. So as we saw in the previous slides, so water seeps through from upstream to downstream. So when the water seeps, it exerts some drag force on the soil. So what happens is, if this is the soil particle, force acts tangentially towards it. So there is a upward component of force in the downstream. Here it is acting this way, but if you go towards the downstream and near the edge set, there is a upward component of force, let us call this F1, and this soil is submerged, so there is a submerged weight of soil. So when F1, this seepage force, is greater than the submerged weight of soil, what happens is the effective stress is zero. So it creates some sort of quicksand condition and the soil is washed away. So that is known as dislodging of soil. So if the soil is washed away here, then the next particle gets affected. Slowly it keeps on getting washed away, and there's a hole. Hole slowly propagates from downstream to upstream in backward direction. So this formation of connected voids, that is, it keeps on forming voids which may go into a hollow kind of structure, that is known as pipe. So that is why it is known as piping failure. So if there is a hollow part, obviously the structure will try to subside into this hollow part, and because of which it fails. So that is known as piping failure. So how to prevent this piping failure? One is, you can increase the seepage path. So at the exit there is less gradient. So that can be done with the help of downstream cutoff piles. So it has to go through. And also what you can do is, you can provide something called inverted filter. So at the downstream, if you provide inverted filter, it is like you provide some drainage for the seepage water to escape, so that it doesn't cause the soil particles to dislodge. So that is one way of preventing piping. So the main idea is to increase the seepage path length. So the next two things are due to surface flow. One is the rupture of floor due to suction caused by hydraulic jump. So when water goes, there is a hydraulic jump. When this hydraulic jump acts in the upward direction, in that direction of uplift pressure, so it adds to the uplift pressure, so sufficient floor thickness to be provided to prevent this. That is one. And another is scouring on upstream or downstream of the weir. So when water flows and if the gates are open, what happens is, here the particles are scoured, so soil erosion takes place. So that is very disadvantage, and the weir will fear because of that. So what you do is, you provide something called launching aprons. So launching aprons is nothing but some loosely packed stones. So what happens is when scour forms, there is a gap which is starting to form, and this stone starts settling in this gap and help preventing the scour. These stones settle in the scoured areas. So that is how you should prevent, you should be preventing scour. So for these conditions, the weir is designed, and there are majorly two theories. One is Blick's creep theory and another is Koestler's theory. This is what we will be seeing in the next videos, and we will also see about Lane's weighted creep theory, which is a modification of Blick's theory. Thanks guys for watching the video.